What's going on, gamers? Today we're going to be looking at the Ender Storage mod and even how to install it onto your Apex Minecraft server. Before we get into this tutorial, don't forget to give it a like, subscribe, and click the notification bell so you can stay up to date on every video we upload, just like this one. When you're playing on your Minecraft world, you're going to run out of space in your Ender chest despite having shulker boxes inside of them. This restricted storage can pose issues to you or other players on your server because it limits how many items you can bring when you're exploring or making your base. Solving this situation is done through Ender Storage, a mod that allows for almost endless amount of chest space. It uses the End's massive dimension to store your items via a unique coloring system that's controlled in-game, and you can even craft a special item to access these chests without having to be at its location. And now we're going to go over how to download the mod. We're going to download the mod first because you need to install it on your server and you need to install it on your local Minecraft launcher before you hop onto your server. Hop onto the CurseForge webpage and then go ahead and click on Files. We recommend that you click on View All, but if you see the version that you want, you can go ahead and click on it here. Just make sure that it says recommended. When you find the file that you want, go ahead and click on the name of that file. And then there's going to be a little download button to the right of it, even if you don't click the name. When you download it, it's going to take you to a secondary page where there's going to be a countdown and then the mod will download. Once you've downloaded it, make sure to click and drag the file to another folder that you can remember for later on. Somewhere like your desktop is fine. For the client install, you need to have CodeChickenLib downloaded and the Ender Storage jar. These should be in a folder together. And you're gonna need to launch your Minecraft launcher or CurseForge or whatever launcher you're using to play Minecraft on. Then find your installation and make sure that you access the files. We're gonna go over just regular Minecraft. And for that, you would click on the little folder to the right of your installation. And then this is gonna open up your Minecraft folder where you can then find your mods folder. Then you're gonna find the location where your downloaded mods are at and just highlight them both. And you can right click and drag them. And it's gonna give you the option to copy or move the folders or move the files. Then once your files are moved, you can click back on your Minecraft launcher and simply click on play and you're ready to play Ender Storage. And installing a new server is also super easy. You're gonna wanna jump onto your Apex server panel and then click on stop on the page. Once your server is fully offline and you're sure that your version of Ender Storage is compatible with the mods that you downloaded, you can check at the top or you can scroll down to the game file selection just to be sure. Here, of course, we have Forge and it's compatible with the files that we downloaded on the CurseForge webpage. Now that we're sure that Ender Storage is compatible with our server, we can click on FTP file access and then log in with your information. Once you're logged in, you can go ahead and find your mods folder. In your mods folder, go ahead and click on the upload button on the left-hand side of the page. Now you can open up the folder where you downloaded your mods to. Click and drag both of the mods over to the right side of the page. Now, you're just gonna wait for the files to reach 100% and then click on the name of your server at the top of the page. And from here, you can either start or restart your server to get it back up and running. And now we're gonna go over some cool stuff in the Ender Storage mod. The modded versions of the Ender chests are color coordinated, meaning that items can be stored and used anywhere if the colors match for each chest. For example, if you have all blue dyed chests, then anything inside of it will be shared. However, if you had one chest with red instead, then the items in the other blue chest would not be shared. In other words, you can have essentially unlimited storage with endless amounts of color combinations for your Ender chest. All you need to do is right click the wool spot on top of the chest with colored dye to change it. As for crafting them, you can use 4 blaze rods on each corner slot. 1 wool on the top, a chest in the center, and 2 obsidian on the sides, and then you add an ender pearl at the bottom. And then there's Ender pouches. Instead of using Ender chests to collect items, you can use an Ender pouch. It's essentially the same functionality, and it follows the same color coordination method to store items, which you can automatically apply to the pouch by shift and right-clicking the chest. This may be more convenient than using a block, but it does take space in your inventory. Regardless, it's a useful tool to store items. And for crafting this, you're going to need 4 blaze powder in the corners, 1 ender pearl in the middle, 1 wool block on the bottom, and fill in the rest with 3 pieces of leather. And then of course there's ender tanks. This mod isn't only limited to storing items, but also liquids in the form of ender tanks. The same color coordination from ender chests applied to the tanks. And it's a great way for storing water, for brewing potions, or adding water-related details to your base. It can store 16 buckets of liquid, which should be plenty. However, if it's not plenty, then you can always make additional tanks to collect more. This is made with 4 blaze rods in the corners, 1 wool block on the top, 1 ender pearl on the bottom, a cauldron in the center, and then fill in the rest with obsidian. This last one is also configurable in your Ender Storage CFG file from the config directory via your FTP panel, of course, going through it the same way that you uploaded the mods before. But this last item is the protection block. This mod offers you a setting to lock your ender chest, pouch, or tank with an item. By default, it's a diamond, and you just right-click the block with your diamond in hand, and with ender chest, you shift and right-click on an already locked chest or tank to get the pouch assigned to your username. And you're gonna see a slight change of color to signify that it's locked by you or another user. Having to worry about storing items is solved with the Ender Storage mod due to its unlimited storage capacity. It's all interconnected with the End Dimension and the color system, which means you can be far away from your base and still access all of your gear. Using the pouches is a great way to quickly access your storage without having to place down a chest. This comes in handy when needing health potions while in combat or to store building materials for a new base. Well, folks, that's all we've got for you today. And as always, we hope you enjoy this video, and we hope you had lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.